You will recall, Desiree, the whole chaos in the city of Cape Town. It's us as ANC notified the office of AG that there is something that is going on in terms of corruption. We wrote to the office of the AG and we requested that an investigation must take place in the city of Cape Town, because at the time the annual reports for all the municipalities were issued, and then the AG decided to hold back the annual report of the city of Cape Town. Indeed, AG confirmed that there's a question that must be answered by the city of Cape Town when it comes to the issue of the electric buses, where we suspected that there was a collusion. So we decided as a council that an investigation must take place. Indeed, we can confirm today that as African National Congress, we have vindicated collusion has taken place, corrupt activities, and you will remember that the DA used City of Cape Town as a benchmark to sell their brand across the country. But in this investigation, instead of investigating corruption and maladministration in the City of Cape Town, the DA used this issue to settle political scores, and they reduced the issue of corruption in the City of Cape Town to one individual, that is Patricia Delil. And to our surprise, they knew all along since 2014 that there is corruption. James Self knew about it, Musi Maimane knew about it, even their chief whip at parliament knew about it, and they did nothing about it. They used Delil to campaign for 2016 local government elections. Immediately after they won the two-third majority, they decided to dump her, using this issue of maladministration and corruption in Cape Town to sideline her.
Mr. Don't you think that's where the disconnect comes in? Because on the one hand, you want to blame the party, but you want to absolve the person at the helm of the party. How do you justify that?
Well, we never absolved Delil from the problem. All what we said is that the DA must take a responsibility as an organization. Delil did not go and campaign for herself. Delil campaigned in the card of the Democratic Alliance. It's a party that campaigned, that persuaded voters to vote for it in the city of Cape Town. Therefore, it must be the party that must take a full responsibility in terms of the corruption that is taking place in the city of Cape Town. It must also be the same party, when something is going wrong, that must take a full responsibility. That is leadership. So you can't play double standards when it's good to show the world that you are a well-run city, but when the corruption is uncovered, you reduce that to an individual. So that is our point of departure as African National Congress in the city of Cape Town. So we are saying that we are not absolving any individual, but what we are saying, the party that is responsible for that administration must take a full responsibility.
But you've also come out in support of Delil, also talking about how the DA is selective in how it's dealing with these matters. What do you mean?
Well, we are supporting her on the basis of selective treatment within the Democratic Alliance. I will cite one example. Yesterday, I made a point in council that JP Smith has appointed his secretary without following any due process. And he just elevated this individual to a higher senior position in council. This person does not have any qualification. There was no recruitment process that was followed. And everybody kept quiet. And nobody is taking JP Smith head on. In fact, we are of the view as ANC that the law enforcement department in the city of Cape Town is being run by a syndicate. And there must be proper investigation about a political interference from JP Smith. So the reason that we're saying this, JP Smith is white and Delil is black, and therefore the treatment is different. And in fact, it was confirmed yesterday by the councillors who have resigned, because we've been saying that racism in the DA is in their DNA. It will never change. The only thing that will change in that party is its colors, but their mentality will never change when it comes to racism. And it was confirmed yesterday. And all those councillors that they have resigned, they have cited the selective treatment within the party. They have cited the issue of racism. So we are concerned as African National Congress that taxpayers' money has been used to deal with Delil, yet people in Khayelitsha, they are waiting for services from the city of Cape Town. The city of Cape Town is on fire. We do not see Musi Maimane on the ground dealing with the issues of service delivery. We do not see James Self on the ground dealing with issues of service delivery. The energy that they show to get rid of the lean is the energy that we expect to be shown when we are dealing with issues of service delivery on the ground. The punitive measures are being imposed to citizens of Cape Town when it comes to water tariffs. Nobody is saying anything from the DA leadership about the sufferings of people of Cape Town. All what they are doing, they are spending more time to deal with one individual.
How are you separating dealing with your day-to-day political issues and being seen to be meddling in internal political party matters of another party?
Well, we have a responsibility as the ANC. We are part of that administration. Anything that goes wrong in that administration, we are a voice of the constituency. We are representing a particular constituency there. The DA is not doing us favors. They have bragged that they have won the city of Cape Town with the two-thirds majority. Therefore, they must show leadership. It's clear that the center is not holding in the city of Cape Town. There is no leadership. We are not meddling with the affairs of the DA. All we are guarding against is when the leadership of the DA wants to use government resources to fight their own internal squabbles. That we are not going to allow, because that administration is not an administration of a particular party. It's a multi-party administration. Yes, the DA has been given a mandate by people of Cape Town to govern. Our responsibility as ANC, as an official opposition, is to make them to account to the people of Cape Town.
How is the African National Congress contributing in bringing about solutions for the city of Cape Town in matters such as the provision of water, for argument's sake?
Well, we are saying that the bill system in the city of Cape Town must be looked at. The problems that you experience in Joburg when it comes to billing system, it's here in Cape Town. There are people who are receiving accounts of more than 200,000 per month. People living in Langa, they're receiving accounts of 10,000 rand a month. And we are saying now dam levels are up, but yet the DA administration does not talk about lowering those levels so that they can be a relief to people. What they do, they continue to punish people for complying with water restrictions. So what we are saying is the ANC, this is the time for people of Cape Town to rise and not only leave this matter to opposition parties, but people of Cape Town across political spectrums to take head on this DA administration, because it's clear that the DA administration is taking people of Cape Town for granted. In fact, they are showing a middle finger to the same voters that they put them in office.
Remind us again, as we wrap up this conversation, what was the position of the African National Congress in the drama that we saw in council yesterday?
Well, Desiree, we are not surprised of what happened yesterday. In fact, we expected that, because these people have been denying that there is a problem in the DA. In fact, the party that has been meddling with the affairs of other parties, the DA, because it's been projecting that it's a well-organized party, there are no problems and so forth. So we've been saying that lies have short legs. They don't walk long distance. We have witnessed that yesterday, that even the leadership of the DA descended in Cape Town after that chaos erupted in council. So we're expecting more fireworks, because the reality is that the party cannot control the contradictions anymore within itself. So as the ANC, we're going to continue to play our role as a ruling party. We want to force the DA to take the responsibility about the rot in the city of Cape Town.
Mr. Sotashe is a leader within the African National Congress in the city of Cape Town. Let's take a break.